All right. So you've never seen Mary Poppins.
No.
Let's hear your Mary Poppins.
You got it. Exterior London street, night. We open on a street corner in London, 1916. It's night. The fishmongers shovel piles of fish guts into their gilly buckets. Newspaper selling orphan boys pull rotten melons from the street bins to hollow out and make into shoes for the day. The street is made out of all those square bricks. They're called cobbles. And it's the only type of street in London. The rain comes down in sheets, making the streets splashy and wet, all slick and oily. The cobbles are shiny and black, like a seal's balls. Exterior Big Ben continuous. Big Ben chimes. Dong, dong. You thought of it. It's 2 a.m. A bird and a man with a hammer dressed like one of the Queen's guard people with the big hats come out of the clock and do that cuckoo clock dance shit that the slaves of the cuckoo clock are forced to do every hour on the hour. Like all of us shuffling from bed to work every day, an endless, pointless cycle we trod until we die. We hear footsteps on the cobblestone streets. They get louder and louder. Exterior London street, shanty village. The camera snakes through a village of shanties. Shanties are cardboard homes, and it's fun that it rhymes with panties. Two cockney junkies huddle in front of a fire made from broken up baby cribs and oil.
I'm sick, governor. I'm dying, matey.
I don't say that, love. We'll get you all fixed up tight and shiny, governor.
Do you mind actually doing this like you're shaking, like you're dying of heroin overdose?
Don't say that, love. We'll get you all fixed up tight and shiny, governor. Good as a pair of brand new burning socks, cricket.
Cockney junkie one throws up a bunch of blood.
Am I making raspberry jam out of me talking to old governor?
If we can just make it to the morrow, love, then we'll quit. Then things will be right again.
Footsteps approach. The camera sees a gold buckle on a plain boot. Buckles, then it pans up the dress of a simple housewoman. An umbrella hides her face. Huh? That is you. That's you. You figure. It is mysterious. It is Mary. It is you. It's a reveal.
I even wrote figure on the front.
It's a reveal.
Kyle didn't highlight it, so.
Holy shit.
You want to give her?
Yeah, now I'll lead you in. So you can get the suspense. Footsteps approach. The camera sees a gold buckle on a plain boot. Then it pans up the dress of a simple housewoman. An umbrella hides her face.
Need something to help you through the night?
A gloved hand holds up a ball of black tar opium.
Yes, that should set my mind straight. Hand her over.
The opium floats from the hand, turns into a sinewy alien liquid like the Venom's costume from the old comic books, not like the new shit in the trailer. I haven't seen a movie yet. It sucks into the nose and mouth of the sick junkie. He seizes and sits up.
Crikey! I'm high as a bird's fart. Thank you!
You know what they say? A little bit of sugar makes the medicine go down.
What?
A laser bolt shoots from the top of the figure's umbrella and hits the junkie in the abdomen. He completely turns inside out. There's fucking guts everywhere.
What the fuck? Why is this happening?
She lowers the umbrella. It's Mary Poppins.
The name's Mary, and you picked the wrong night to do drugs on my family street. Tell your other sick junkie friends Mary Poppins is coming.
The other junkie scrambles into the night. Mary saunters over to it, this twitching, groaning pile of meat that used to be a man.
Makes me sick.
She pulls a knife from her boot and stabs it slowly where the brain is exposed to the air. She sings a song about how envelopes are food for mailboxes or some other dumb British nanny shit. Feels good to get it out.
Envelopes are food for mailboxes.
I don't know what any of the songs are. I know there's coal and there's penguins. Interior, a rich family house day. A father is sucking on his pipe in the kitchen.
Where are the pots and pans, mother?
Mother enters. She wears a fur jacket and is sucking on a 2-gallon martini.
How am I to know where the bedevil is Mary?
Mary Poppins materializes in the living room out of 1,000 crows. This would be so fucking metal, dude. Just to see it, just like all these crows flying in. I was having a good time with this. She wears the power gem of Gurkul. It is shaped like a monkey's heart and is the source of all her power. She stole it from a Mongolian warlord when she was the head courtesan of a mysterious group of sorceresses, the Guild of Blackened Sparrows. They served the Lord's physical pleasures for many generations, but when Mary stole the gem, she turned the generals into screaming stains on the rocks they called home. Now she's a housekeeper like Tony Danza.
Breakfast is ready for the family.
Two adorable children tumble from downstairs. Lucy is gangly and sweet, and Tweedle, her younger brother, who is in a wheelchair bound after his legs were crushed by a merchant's cart.
Mary's home!
Mary sings a song about breakfast, about eggs are magical, there's shit about toast in it. The pancakes are dancing in the air and everyone's laughing and clapping and just like madness. I like the idea that everyone's gone insane with the song and they kind of, like, their bodies are trying to jerk back and forth.
Ha ha, there's a pancake on the ceiling.
Delightful.
All in a day's work.
If you can make food dance, can you perchance fix my legs, Mary?
There is a full 5 minutes of silence. I just love, it's just, everyone just.
His leg stops. Oh my
God. It's lunchtime.
Mary sings a song about making lunch. They all clap and laugh.
Oh, Mary, what would we do without you?
My power gem keeps the sun from exploding.
Maybe we can have another conversation about my legs.
There's a commotion from the living room.
It's my soot-covered chimney, friend.
Dick Van Dyke crawls out of the chimney like the girl from The Ring. Everyone screams. His teeth are so big they chomp and chomp. You can hear them clack together miles away.
Why, I'm 109 years old. But I can still dance, Mary.
Show him, Dick Van Dyke.
Dick Van Dyke shuffles around like a scarecrow on fire. His knees can fold backwards. He sings a song about how nothing can ever be cleaned enough. The world is dirty and can never be clean, no matter how hard he sweeps. Tweedle starts crying.
No, no, Tweedle!
Mary wiggles her nose and Tweedle's frown literally turns upside down, black hole sun style.
Have you met my new girlfriend, Mary?
Oh, I kind of thought you and I were an item.
Oh, we were? This is just someone I'm seeing until we were exclusive.
So you want to label our relationship? I thought after our discussion at Joshua Tree that we were past labels.
Oh, yeah, about that. This is Jenny.
A penguin comes in the front door.
You've been dating this cartoon penguin?
Hell yeah, she can't get pregnant.
They all laugh knowingly. Mary winks and Tweedle grows new legs, but they are spider legs.
The end.
That is it. Thank you guys. So fucking funny.
Oh boy. Henry Zebrowski, everybody.
You guys are great.
Please applaud again for Blair Socci, Langston Kerman, Danny Jolles, Dave Ross, Charla Lauriston, so Chris Garcia. Thank you guys so much for coming to the show. Yeah, we're all good. That's the end. I want to give our love to...